give a big thank you and share some love with our weather team, because our Storm 5 team, they were here throughout that for us. And Lelan, you all gave us a big warning that this was on the way, and I have no doubt that you guys saved lives. So thank you so much for all the work that you put into
and the one that started out in Nashville just intensified very quickly there and then dropped down. But by the time we made it into East Nashville, the warnings had been out, and then our friends of the Weather Service, we relay the warnings, and our friends of the Weather Service are the ones who actually issue the warnings, did a good job in staying on top of that.
Yeah, we have a really interesting and important partnership with them, because not every city has a local branch of the National Weather Service like we do right here in Nashville.
Yes.
So you guys know them pretty well.
Yeah, we get together. As a matter of fact, Bree and I were with them on Saturday, along with everybody, just about everybody who loves media weather in this town, with the other stations as well, at Severe Weather Awareness Day. But that's part of a partnership there to let folks say, hey, it's severe weather season. Mm-hmm. Some folks say, is this early? Well, severe weather season actually in Tennessee started on Sunday, March 1.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Wasted no time.
Yeah, but I'll say this too, for Tennessee weather, yeah, this is severe weather season when the peak time for tornadoes go up. But here's our deal. We've actually had tornadoes touch down in Tennessee in every month of the year. So you've always, always need to be prepared. And as we saw, unfortunately, with this, have a way to get information in the middle of the night. With this set up, we do have a host of schools that are going to be out. Now, some of these will be out here for actually a couple of days. Nashville will make a decision a little bit later in the day on how long they plan to stay out. They'll decide whether or not they've got enough electricity back later today, or even some school damage there. I know Robert Churchwell Magnet Museum in North Nashville took a big hit for yesterday. But if you look at this, kind of gives you a mental look at the line. There was one fatality in Benton County. So that storm cell hits Benton County. That same storm cell then makes its way here. So not doing much in Humphreys County, Dixon County, and then gets into Davidson County and then intensifies. So we know that part of this line in Germantown is an EF3 by Toon Airport and EF2. Our friends from the Weather Service will go back out later today and see if they can connect the dots from Smith County, Jackson, and Putnam counties there to see, number one, we know it was one parent cell, but to see if it was one long track, two long track tornadoes, if it was on the ground for that entire time, or through the way maybe it lifted up and then dropped back down over in Smith County or Jackson and Putnam County. So that'll be the determination later today. You always determine that EF scale after the fact by surveying the storm damage. All right, for today, 52 at 9 o'clock, 62 at noon, 65 at 3 o'clock. Some scattered showers in our southern areas. We see a little rain on radar in Lawrence County, but right now not seeing much there. There may be a few sprinkles out of Wayne and Lawrence counties for us this morning. Here's a look at what's happening for you right now with our satellite photograph. More of the rain south of the Volunteer State, but a sprinkle or two from Lawrence County and back over into Wayne County, even Hardin County around Savannah, not out of the question for us. ExactTrack picks up on some of that spotty activity as we go through the day. But then overnight tonight, a warm front lifting to the north. That's going to spread more moisture in here for us overnight tonight and for tomorrow. Scattered showers as we go through the day on Thursday. And temperatures, though, still not on the bad side. Upper 50s near normal tomorrow. 65 today. Tomorrow, 59. Going into Friday, 51. Weekend looking good. We're at 57 Saturday and then 64 Sunday. Another chance at rain and a few thunderstorms on Monday and Tuesday.